Hi everyone, you're on How Fix It. In this video guide, I'll show you how to replace the battery on the DJI remote controller. This controller comes with drones such as Mavic Air 2, Air 2S, Mavic 3, Mini 2, and Mini 3 Pro. To disassemble the DJI controller, you will need the following tools: screwdriver set, tweezers, plastic pry tools, metal spudger. Also, I recommend using a magnetic mat during the repair process, which is especially useful in the case of the DJI controller. Throughout this disassembly, keep track of each screw so you can put them back in the right places. This will help successfully reassemble your controller. And don't worry about losing any of the screws. All of them will definitely remain on the magnetic mat. In the description, I left links where to buy all the necessary tools. Let's start disassembling the controller. Remove the two screws on the bottom of the controller where the joystick storage slot is located. And on the top of the controller, there are two screws hidden under the rubber tabs. Let's move on to opening the remote controller housing. Place the fingertips of both hands on the top of the controller housing and begin to open the case, separating the front and back panels. Now there is a gap, through which it will be easier to open the controller body. Take a metal spudger, which is the most suitable tool in this case, and proceed to open the controller. There is thermal paste on the back of the metal panel on the motherboard. Keep this paste. It will be reused when reassembling the controller. Before further disassembly of the controller, disconnect the battery wires from the main board. The DJI remote controller uses two batteries, type of 18650. You can install new batteries using this part number. Or if you have soldering experience, you can re-solder the wires to new 18650 battery cells. I recommend replacing two cells at once, preferably from the same manufacturer with the same battery capacity. In the description, I left links where you can buy a battery for the DJI remote controller. Plug in the charging cable and check the battery charge indicator. Before closing the controller housing, make sure the flight mode switch is set correctly. I really appreciate you watching my video guides. You can ask all additional questions regarding the repair in the comments. Thanks for watching, and have a safe flight.